Are you satisfied now?
To tell you the truth, I'm a little bit upset by this adventure.
Are you frightened?
I? Oh, I don't know what fear is, but I'm shocked.
Tell me, what impressed you most about it down there?
The heat, man. I thought you were taking me into the very depth of hell.
That's it. You hit it the first time, Phelan. The heat. The terrific heat. You know what this whole island is?
No, what?
It is a submerged volcano.
Well, what of it?
Simply this. Within its walls, deep down beneath the sea, great masses of lava, terrifically hot.
Very interesting.
What is the result? Why, the shaft of that volcano becomes a heat siphon. It sends a current of warm water upward, which in turn draws cold water to take its place. Cold water from the very bottom of the sea.
Indeed.
Think for a moment what that means. It means that that water there comes up directly from a world no man has ever seen. The deepest part of the sea.
Very interesting indeed, and someday I'll come back and hear all about it. But will you pardon me if I tell you the urgent business that brought me from the mainland?
Oh, I beg your pardon, Taylor. I'm afraid I ride my hobby in and out of season.
We alone? Can we be overheard? Old friend, I'm about to put my liberty, perhaps even my life, in your hands.
Well, what do you mean?
Within a month, a revolution will take place. Silently, bloodlessly, I hope, which will put a new king on the throne of Hetria. That king will be
myself.
Why not? Why not I as well as another? The present king is old and feeble. The succession is gone. My family is one of the most powerful in Hetria.
I know you. All this is out of my knowledge. Who am I? I'm a scientist, a student who asks nothing but to be left alone. Here on my island, we do think of kings or rank or power. Here, the humblest workman in my shops, the peasant who tills my field, is my equal. We work with but one end, to study, to learn, to be free, to seek happiness, each in his own way.
Very pretty, Andre. But you're also one of the most powerful nobles in the realm. And I thought, my friend.
I am. I wish you well. All I ask is you to let me forget what you've said. Forget it absolutely and go back to my shops, my laboratory. Come now. We'll strike a bargain. I will refrain from riding my hobby and boring you. You refrain from boring me.
Hobby?
Look.
What?
Look here.
Well, what?
Look at this.
Sir.
What on earth is it? All that row about a bit of... Well, what is it? Bone?
All right, boys.
I'm afraid you might be bored.
I? No, I promise you. But what is it?
Come on and I'll show you. I told you that this natural current inside the island draws the water up from the depths of the sea. Now, at first I studied this unending stream. I found bits of fragments such as this, pieces of bone, debris, just curiosity, nothing more. Then, bit by bit, I began to discover something that led me to one of the most astounding discoveries in the history of science.
What do you mean?
Fallon, life began in the water. We scientists believe that this was a liquid world in the beginning. Life as we know it started then. Then, out of the slime and the drying mud, man marched upward to his present place in the universe.
Yes.
Suppose that in all the ages that man has been developing to his present state, that a distant cousin of his, starting from the same source, has been going through a similar process of evolution under the water.
You mean creatures like men actually living deep down in the sea?
Precisely.
Oh, but how do they live? How do they breathe?
How do fishes live? How do fishes breathe? What are all the legends of water nymphs and mermaids and larvae except proof that in the dim dawn of time, man knew of these distant cousins? Or even then, starting their downward march as man was starting upward?
Oh, nonsense. The sort of fairy tale you tell the children in the nursery.
But I have proof of it.
Where?
Bit by bit, I've collected the fragments that have come up to me from the depths. They don't come under any classification known to science. No one has seen such creatures anywhere on land or sea.
Nor have you, Andre.
No, that's true. But I've built one. Bit by bit, bone by bone.
Where? Good heavens, Andre. Do you mean there are creatures like this actually living under the sea?
Living? Perhaps dwelling in populous cities. Who knows? The size and shape of the skull indicate a brain beyond that of any living creature, except man himself. This latest find fills out the outline of the jaw. Observe.
A very interesting theory, Andre. But it'll always be only a theory. No one will ever know what lies at the bottom of the ocean.
Don't be too sure. I'm planning to explore the ocean's depths now.
How?
Sit down. Now, you've often wondered what need I had for workshops, a shipyard, all hidden away here on mysterious island. Hubert, I'm building a boat that will descend to the bottom of the ocean.
Many do that, friend Andre.
But this one is going to come up again. Oh, I've planned it very carefully, the work of years. It will succeed. I know it will succeed.
An armed vessel, Andre?
Of course. Who knows what perils we'll meet at the bottom of the ocean?
A ship that will sail under the sea to attack? Andre, with that, we could conquer the world.
If I thought my vessel would be used in the slaughter of mankind, I'd never build it. No. It's for science only.
Run away! Run away! Take it fast. Ready, all? Quick to your post. Watch those dials.
Diving ship number one reporting. 230-foot depth. Distance 14 miles. All well. Nikolai Roget reporting.
Take it! Get off! Oh! Oh! Midnight, then. Come up without a ripple. Just beyond the rocks.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Shepard. Thank you.